Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you for moderator. My respectable to professor, doctor, college, and friends, it is an honor for me to have a chance to present our research work in front of you all. The title of my presentation today is Drying Gayo Coffee under natural processing by using modified Hohenheim Aceh solar tunnel dryer in Gayo highline. We already know that Arabica Gayo coffee from Aceh has specialty and is well known worldwide. And in the coffee processing, there are about two methods that can be applied, that is dry and wet method. Of course, the common method that is used by our farmers is the open sun drying method through natural or dry method. Recently, we have also a new product called wine coffee that has strong and best flavor. And the total drying time needed to dry coffee under natural processing is more than 2 weeks. Moreover, the time needed to produce wine coffee is more than 3 weeks. And this problem becomes harder for Gayo Highline since the area has low daily temperature in average of 26 degrees centigrade. So, the objective of our study is to examine the performance of modified type Hohenheim Aceh solar tunnel dryer. We had conducted the experiment in Mahbengi village, sub-district of Bebesan, district of Aceh Tengah, province of Aceh. We evaluated a solar tunnel dryer type Hohenheim Aceh that has 6 meter length and 0.8 meter width. The dryer has 33% solar collector and 66% drying area. And the dryer also has 9 drying boxes and each of them has area of 0.4 meter square. We dried about 9 kilograms of coffee cherries during the experiment. During the drying process, we had evaluated some parameter, for example, the drying temperature and humidity hourly by using hygrothermal clock meter. We also measure the weight changes of sample that we put in the small aluminum box in the center of the drying box. And at the end, we calculated the drying rate by using the ratio of moisture dry basis changes to the drying times. And the moisture content of coffee bean also measured by using the oven method. Now you can see the result of our work about the drying temperature among the days. Since we have the initial moisture of coffee cherry at 70%, we need about 10 days to dry the coffee cherry until it has the moisture below 14%. We can see from this chart that in the drying chamber, we have higher temperature compared to the ambient temperature. The average temperature in the drying chamber was about 35.6 degrees centigrade, while the average temperature at environment was about 25.8 degrees centigrade. So we can see that the dryer can increase the drying temperature about 10 degrees centigrade, and this fact is believed to faster the drying process. Since the dryer has also about 9 drying boxes along the tunnel, we had also evaluated the temperature among them. We can see here that the average of drying boxes temperature was 35.6 degrees centigrade by deviation among the drying boxes about 2 to 2.9 degrees centigrade. So then we can say that the drying temperature along the tunnel was uniform. The temperature also decreased as the drying boxes number increased because the position of those drying boxes increased from the solar collector area. As I had explained before, in this design we had improved the drying capacity of the dryer by reducing the solar collector area. So we can conclude that this design can be used in Indonesian climate. And now, the second important factors to support the drying process is humidity. We can see here that the average drying chamber humidity is about 42.3%, while the average environment humidity was 45.5%. In this case, Gayo Highland has low humidity and the use of solar tunnel dryers still can reduce the humidity to support the drying process. And now I want to show you about the result of moisture decrease during the drying process of coffee cherries. From 9 drying boxes, we have selected the drying box number 1 and number 6 to show you how fast the drying process can be reached by using solar tunnel dryer type Hohenheim Aceh. If we compare to the open sun drying system, we can see that the moisture is reduced about 0.1x72% per hour, while by using the solar dryer, we can see that we can reduce about 0.841x% per hour and 0.7231% per hour. So we can see that the use of solar tunnel dryer type Hohenheim Aceh could faster the drying process than the open sun drying method about fourfold. This fact also supported by the result of drying rate calculation, where by using the solar tunnel dryer type Hohenheim Aceh, we can see that the drying rate were higher than that of the open sun drying method. You can see here the maximum drying rate in the drying chamber was about 13.8% dry basis per hour, while the drying rate maximum at open sun drying system was only about 6.9% dry basis per hour. So we have taken some conclusion from this study that first, the dryer design has a good performance under Gayo Highland climate and can be used in the application of coffee drying. The use of this dryer could faster the drying process, and we also believe that the dryer can improve the product quality since the product is protected from all contamination during the drying process. And the application of the dryer would bring benefit for farmers economically, and this method can be suggested for wine coffee processors. Thank you very much for your attention. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.